Everyone. So another question about the Node.js, about the deployment and maintaining the server up and running. So if you are just writing node index.js, that is not enough when there are multiple requests is coming in and you have a traffic on your APIs. Then I will suggest you should use some kind of a process manager like PM2, using which you can create a multiple instance of your application, like PM2startapp.js. If you type pm2startapp.js3, then it will create a 3 parallel instance of your application. So your application will be divided into the multiple instances like this. And when you do the pm2 list, so you will see all the processes running for your one single application. Okay, so pm2 is one of the popular process manager for application which is actually running your single Node.js application in the cluster mode, and where it has, like, if you can create a 3 instance, 4 instance, and it is running all those instances inside a cluster. It is doing the log, it is doing the monitoring, it is keeping your application up and running. So similarly, you can use some kind of a profiling tool for Node.js logging. So for the Node.js logging, I will suggest you to use a Winston. So Winston logger you can use, that is actually used for logging in the Node.js application. So there are different logging modules, like Express logger is there, but Winston is actually creating the stream, the logging stream continuously. So there are a lot of advantages of using the Winston on top of other logger. So for logging purpose, you can define your logging mode, log info, warn, error. And then you can log your data inside some external file. So I use in all the project as a Winston logger, which is logging your metadata, your request which is coming in for the different clients. You can do all those things. Setup is simple. You just do a require and then winston.log info, define the level somewhere and do the logging. Okay, similarly, we have already talked about the debugging. You can use a Node Inspector, you can use a Visual Studio Code, you can use a Chrome plugin to do the debugging. And for the deployment, you can choose any server. Just write your npm scripts, like npm start, which will look for the main file, which is index.js or server.js, which contains your code to start the server. Okay. And rest of the thing which you can look for inside the Node.js website about the complete documentations. Current version is 9.7, but if you use a Node version manager, you can switch to the different versions. I use a current stable 8.0, but you can keep your version updated with the latest one.